Welcome to the Daily Prophetic Word for Thursday, the 30th of May 2019. The word is given from the Spirit and is about blindness has covered your eyes. Please stay until the end of this video so that I can continue with our rapture timeline. Now let's start with the Daily Prophetic Word for the 30th of May 2019. Blindness has covered your eyes. Generational curses and acts of my enemy have blinded you for my glory. But I have heard your prayers for rescue, and I am on my way. I will remove the blindness that has covered your eyes, and you will see the first time my power and my glory. You will turn from the world and towards my heavenly kingdom. Blindness has covered your eyes. Understanding and freedom will open your eyes for the doings of my enemy, and from now onwards you will see clearly. I will make the crooked way straight and will fill the empty wells with water. You will see what many generations have yearned to experience. Open eyes will see the true path towards my paradise, and nobody will stumble on the new journey, because their eyes remain wide open. Blindness has covered your eyes, but I will heal your sight and mend your thoughts. This was a daily prophetic word given by the Spirit for Thursday the 30th of May 2019. Now, let us continue with our rapture timeline. Let me see if I can go to the other. Yes, here we are. This is our timeline, either for June or July to July or July to August 2019. And last time we went up to the little boys on the 26th of June. The little boys are for me. This is when the first seal is opened and the raven and dove that Noah released will be sent out. The dark forces and the light forces. Antichrist and the spirit of Elijah. On the 27th of June, there is a day that is like a death, and at the same time is like a birthday. And I received the information that from this day forward, from this 27th, either June or July, we have to be at a certain place before the 3rd of July or the 3rd of August. Do not ask me exactly what that will be, but it will be a day of death and birthday at the same time. So a new level, some transformation into something totally new. And then on the 28th to 29th of June, love is in the air. This could be the second escape. The first escape will be earlier, when Jesus is calling his bride into his place. But a greater escape might take place on the 28th, 29th of June or 28th, 29th of July. But I don't think so it will be July. It should be. We will see. Let's just say it that way. We will see. On the 31st then of June, there will be a red balloon. A red balloon was seen. So that means clearly, attention, warning, war is coming. On the 1st of July, then there was a sign of Mary Magdalene. And it was said, Mother of many, Mother of the nations, Mother of Zion, with the daughter of Zion and the daughter of Israel. This has some relation to the Revelation 12 sign. And Mary Magdalene was the first after Jesus' resurrection at the grave. So she was the first one who believed in his new level after he was resurrected in his transformed body. She saw him in the first person, she saw Jesus in his transformed body. So this has something to do with this one. As I say before, there will be a new level, a new way. if it's for the people who have escaped or if it's for the people who have remained, because for the remnant, so that they are walking now on a new level, because we all have to reach Mount Zion, I do not know. The 2nd of July, you are called forth. Now the nations are waiting for the harvest workers. Whoever has not gone in the first escape of the bride is now called forth into a new level and called forth to be a harvest worker. And now you're called forth to take your positions in the nations. The 3rd of July, we have a whole new world. The seals are open and judgments are now on the way. From the 3rd of July, anything can happen. And I believe that on the 4th of July, the dress rehearsal starts. The seal period is a dress rehearsal for the trumpet period. It is not the trumpet, it is the seal period. And from this day, on the 4th of July, from this dress rehearsal now, I also believe that war cannot be stopped anymore. No matter how much you will pray, no matter what will happen, war cannot be stopped anymore. War will come to Jerusalem, war will come to America, war will come to the world. On the 10th of July, we will have a change. Now it will be a complete change into a new level for the remnant. The Elijah spirit will now reach all the harvest workers. And I believe this day has something to do with the true Pentecost. The 10th to the 11th will be the true Pentecost according to the Father. Not according to our worldly thinking, not according to our worldly calendars, but according to Yahweh. And on the 11th of July, I had seen the mothership. Mothership could be now different things. Mothership could be something that could be related to aliens, but I do not think so, because that would be far too early for the alien deception. It could be that now the daughter of Zion gives birth to the remnant children. We see it in Revelation 12. Where there will be in Revelation 12:17, where you see the remnant children, this one who obey the commandments of God given at Mount Horeb and have the testimony of Jesus Christ together. These remnant children might now be born, and that's the reason why there is a mothership. Can also have something to do with establishing of societies of the rose, the assemblies of love and righteousness in the nations, so that these will be the spots of mothership. That could also be. And also a mothership is a main ship from where smaller ships will go out. Also this could be a representation of this smaller ships being the societies of the rose in the nations. On the 13th of July, there is gifts giving and a Christmas day. I really ask what this could be. But I believe now the gifts are poured out so that the remnant can shine as Jesus did. This is like the fiery tongues coming onto the disciples. They are very close. All this is around the Pentecost timing. On the 16th of July, we have now two mantles, two coverings, and a big tower. And this again refers to the raven and the dove. Twins, one dark and one white. But it's also again still related to Pentecost, when now you are covered in the two mantles, like Elijah was taken up to heaven, but his mantle came down to Elisha. So it has something to do with this. And the 19th of July, we have now the start of the really sealed timing, the tsunami and the tower. This is now the destruction of America, with tsunamis either on the west or east coast or on both coasts, and then followed by the destruction in other parts of the world. From the 19th of July, the seal period now is starting. Either the Red Rider and all the following rider after him. On the 20th of July, priestly crowns are given, because now your time as a remnant to shine has come. because destruction has reached the world. So now it is very important to have the societies of the rose to gather the people, and the remnant will receive their crown to bring in the harvest. 22nd of July, the gathering of my sheikhs will start. So now the harvest starts in plenty. Now the Father will take his children under his wings of protection. So come together in love, unity and support. Come into the societies of the rose, because the bedtime has started and we must walk towards Mount Zion to be at his holy place, to be raptured into paradise at the sixth seal. But until then, a bedtime is there. So please, come together, support one another. Come together into societies of the rose. On the 23rd of July, wear my crowns. Now the harvest workers have taken position in the nations. Societies of the rose are starting. This is a timeline that was given to me. It might look for some of you people strange. When I received it first, I also thought, oh, there are so many images inside there, so many patterns, Bible of old times inside, of Elijah, of Moses, of Exodus, of bringing in the harvest, of escape, of rapture, of so many things. So just look at it slowly, slowly. And if you have questions, send your questions to triplegrace55@gmail.com. Also join us at our homepage at triplegrace.com and become a member. Join us. Establish societies of the rose. Help us to bring forth videos. Watch all the videos in our New Journey to Paradise series or in our mini-series that we produce for Patreon. Be part of it. Come together now. Support one another. And be protected under the wings of Yahweh, under the wings of the Father. Thank you that you are here with me. Thank you as always that you have joined and come. I know it's not always easy to understand all these things, but slowly by slowly we bring more clarity and more wisdom inside. Oh, that's the reason why it's very important not only to join Triple Grace, but also to watch all the videos in the series, so that you have an understanding. If you do not understand something, then watch it again. And if then still questions are remaining, send the question to me, either through the forum, through the support link, or to triplegrace55@gmail.com. I will answer all your questions. I thank you that you are here with me, and I will see you again for tomorrow for the next daily prophetic word. I'm Michael. May God bless you and your family abundantly. Maranatha.